In my Bible study time, there's several things that I try to keep my eyes open for. But there's one thing in particular that, for me at least, it seems to stand out quite often. And those are the contrasting statements. Take, for instance, the book of Proverbs. Proverbs is filled with these statements. Solomon will say things like, if you're wise, you'll live this way, and here's the blessings that you can expect as a result. And if you're foolish, you're going to ignore the wisdom I'm giving you, and, well, you're going to suffer the consequences for it. So I'm reading through Matthew's gospel, and I came upon this contrasting statement that is unique in the gospels. I do mean unique. In fact, not just in the Gospels, but I don't find this put together, this phrase, anywhere else in the New Testament, anywhere else in the Bible, for that matter. Let me give you the background. Jesus has told his disciples, we need to go to the other side of the lake. So they get in the boat and they begin their journey, and Jesus promptly falls asleep. He's sleeping peacefully. His disciples are anything but peaceful. That's the first contrast that we notice in this story. The Synoptic Gospels, Matthew, Mark, and Luke, all describe this storm as furious, and they share some details like the water is coming over the edge of the boat. So you can imagine the disciples are probably bailing as fast as they can, and they're using all the skill that they have, and it's not getting them anywhere. And so eventually they have to wake up Jesus, and they're like, we're going down here. Now, Jesus is going to speak a word to calm the storm, but before he does, here's this contrasting statement that I want you to notice. Matthew chapter 8, verse 26, Jesus replied, you of little faith, why are you so afraid? You hear the contrast? You of little faith, why are you so afraid? Small faith, big fear. That's the contrast that he points out to us. In fact, the word that he uses here, delios, if you go to Strong's Greek dictionary, it says dread by implication, faithless. In other words, what Jesus is saying is when faith has been removed from your heart, it creates a vacuum that naturally brings in fear. When faith has gone, fear sucks in there. He uses another word, and you may have heard this phrase before, O ye of little faith. Well, that's actually there. If you come here and read this account in Matthew's Gospel in the King James Version, you'll read that phrase, O ye of little faith. But in the Greek, it's only one word, oligopistos. The root word, pistos, is faith, but that prefix at the beginning, oligos, can mean three different things, really. It can mean, I jotted it down in my notes this way, it can mean if you're talking about quantity, it's things that are small. If you're talking about time frame, it's something that is short. And if you're talking about intensity, it's something that's very slight. So in other words, what Jesus is saying here when he says oligopistos here, he's really saying that your faith is immature, it hasn't grown yet, or that you're not applying it to this situation, or you're not applying it with enough intensity in this situation. Now, this word oligopistos is not used very often. It's only used five times in the New Testament. So it's used here, but I want you to see the other definitions because I think it rounds this definition out. It helps us understand it a little bit more. So it's used here in Matthew chapter 8, but earlier Jesus used it in Matthew chapter 6, and he also uses it in Luke chapter 12 to tell the same story. When people are saying, I'm a little concerned about what I'm going to eat, what I'm going to wear, what kind of shelter I'm going to have. And Jesus says, don't have that little faith, but instead understand that your heavenly Father knows that you need these things. In fact, he knows that you need them before you even ask for them. And Jesus then points us to, he says, look at the flowers, look at the birds, just like Jesus or like your heavenly Father takes care of those little things, he's going to take care of you as well. So don't let your faith be little. Don't let it be small in quantity. Don't let it be slight in its intensity. Don't let the time frame just be a really short time frame. Hang in there. God is going to provide for these things. It also shows up in Matthew's Gospel in chapter 14 when Peter is walking on the water. Now remember, Peter does walk on the water. He takes steps towards Jesus, but then when he takes his eyes off Jesus and he begins to look at the waves, then he begins to sink. And Jesus uses the same word there, oligopistos. He said, Why didn't you continue to use your faith? You had faith. Why didn't you continue to use it? And then it's used one other time in Matthew's Gospel, chapter 16, where Jesus says to his followers, beware of the yeast of the Pharisees and the Sadducees. What was the yeast of the Pharisees and Sadducees? It wasn't putting their faith in God. It was putting their faith in their religious practices. We can be good with God because we're doing these things, not because we trust God and we have faith in him, but because we trust our works, our religious things. And he called that yeast that slowly starts coming in. So in all of these things, here's what we see. In mathematical circles, it would be called inversely proportionate. Inversely proportionate, which basically means when fear goes up, faith has to go down. But the opposite is true too. When faith goes up, it drives out fear. There is that inverse proportionate. Now, notice the mathematical symbol for inverse proportionality. Maybe you've seen a symbol like that somewhere before. It's a symbol that the early church used to symbolize Jesus. It's called an ichthus. And I think that that's very telling for us. When we begin to feel fear in our hearts, our eyes start going other places. In the case of these disciples, their eyes were going on all of the water that was washing into their boats. In the case of Peter walking on the water, his eyes went off Jesus and went to the waves. In the case of when he's talking to us about being fearful, we're looking to how can I provide for my needs? So I got to get food. I got to get clothing. I got to get shelter. And what do I have to do? Then he says, put your eyes back on your heavenly Father. And the same thing with warning him of the yeast of the Pharisees and the Sadducees. What do I have to do? What religious practices, what boxes do I have to check? And Jesus says, get your eyes off of that and put your eyes on me instead. And so, friends, we have to do the same thing. When we feel fear come into our heart, we have to say, and let me go back to that definition of oligopistos. If we say our fear is small in quantity, the Bible tells us that our faith comes from hearing the word of God. We need to go back to God's word if we have small quantity faith. But it also says that sometimes it's slight in its intensity. I think that sometimes we tend to go, well, Jesus, you provided over there, but this is a different situation. This is a unique situation. We have to remind ourselves that Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever, that God's promises are applicable eternally, wherever the situation we're in. But then also, I think the other one is the shortness of time. Sometimes we say, well, I've been in this too long, and so now I need to take matters into my own hands, instead of saying, I'm going to wait on God and his timing to get me out of this. Because you know what, friends? We're only going to grow our faith by going through those hard times. There is no other way to grow and stretch and expand our faith and grow its intensity and its quantity and its stick-to-itiveness we have to go through the storms. We have to go through the trials. And Jesus knows perfectly how to take us through those trials, not to put us in a position where we're going to be overwhelmed. That's what Jesus taught us to pray in Matthew chapter 6. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. Don't take us into these situations that we're not ready for yet. And he's never going to do that. So check your heart. When fear comes in, remember, when fear comes in, that's only because the faith has gone out and it's created a vacuum for the fear to come in. So just like fear and faith are inversely proportionate to each other, and that mathematical symbol, let it remind you that your eyes need to go back to Jesus. Keep your eyes on Jesus. Grow your faith. And as your faith grows, the fear has to leave.